everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Anushka and in this video I'm sharing with you all some binge-worthy books which you can read right now. These are definitely unputdownable books. You can read in just two or maybe three sittings. That's how I read these books. These are not just thrillers or, you know, all these common books which you might have heard and also I have recommended a lot of times. But these are some new books I want you all to know about and to pick up right now, because these are plot heavy, character driven, fast paced, and the story is gripping to say the least. So I hope you pick one book for yourself. First book on my list is one of the best character driven novels I've read till now, and it is none other than The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo by Taylor Jenkins Reid. Now once you read this book, you'll realize that it's not really about the seven husbands. That was just a gimmick. It's actually about Evelyn Hugo, the person behind that whole stardom. The story tells you the whole glamorous world of Film City, of sets. Not just that, it's actually about Evelyn Hugo, the brave, the feisty, the bold, the fierce, the decisive woman that she was. When the book starts, she portrays herself as not a good person. She wants to tell the world that she has done many wrong things in her life, but she is up to telling the story. So she hires a less renowned journalist named Monique, which is a surprise, which shocks not only Monique but her office as well, as to why Evelyn wants Monique to write her story, which is revealed in the last part of the book. It is gripping because we get to know everything about her life, all her relationships, all her, you know, rumors. She declares each and everything, and she accepts where she was wrong or where she was right. Next, I have a suspense thriller named Before I Go to Sleep. Now, this is a story which starts an extremely pumped up rate. It is full of suspense. It has a lot of potential when it starts because we have a rare condition here. Our protagonist named Christine, who is in her late 40s, is dealing with amnesia. Now, amnesia is the loss of memories. So each time when Christine sleeps and when she wakes up, she loses all her past memory. She does not know who she is herself. She does not know what this year is, what the date is. She does not know that she has any children or not, who is her husband. Everyone who she sees is a stranger for her. That is very difficult, but she has a husband by her side who shows her photographs every time that she wakes up and tells her that, see, this is the person, this is this person and this is that person. But this is very annoying to her because, you know, you can't live a life like that. So she wants to find out how this happened to her, because her husband tells her that this was an accident. So she wants to find out who did this to her, how did this accident happen, and that's the whole story. That's how, you know, the story is how will she be able to find out who did this to her. Now this is full of suspense, though I predicted the ending, which is why I did not give it a 5-star. But if you ask me, is it binge worthy? Yes, it is. Next, I have an addictive and extremely fast-paced sci-fi novel, which is none other than Ready Player One by Ernest Cline. Now this is a book, as the name suggests, Ready Player One is about this gaming virtual world which is set in 2044. Now the real world in 2044 is dying. Everybody is fighting with themselves. There's poverty, there's lack of everything, there's lack of water and food. But then there's another world in 2044 which is the gaming virtual world known as Oasis. There, everything seems fine. People can be whoever they want to be. And this world known as Oasis, this gaming world, was built up by James Holiday, who suddenly died. And he had a lot of fortune, but he did not have an heir to it. So what he did before dying, he created another game, and whoever wins that game will not only get the access to Oasis, but will also get the whole fortune, like all of his money, all of James Holiday's money. Now, how can I move forward without adding a crime thriller to this binge list? For this list, I have A Good Girl's Guide to Murder by Holly Jackson. This is though a YA, but I'm assuring you, even if you're an adult, you will be hooked on to this book. It is full of suspense, like epitome of suspense. It is well researched, well planned, and of course, well written. The writing style is also extremely unique because it is about this girl named Pippa, who's a 17-year-old nerdy girl, and she's taken up this project as part of a school project to do research on a crime which occurred 5 years ago in her town. A serious, real crime, and that was a murder. So she's on this task and she wants to do this as part of a school project. And because it's like a school project, so you're reading transcripts of her thoughts, of the whole project, of everything going behind. And which is why I said it, the writing style is unique and also the plot as well. As I said, it is full of suspense. So till the end, there are so many suspects in this book. Each and every one is a suspect in this novel. You won't be able to get you won't be able to predict the ending. That's what I want to say about this book. Definitely one of my 5-star rated books, so I highly recommend you all to read it right now. Next, I have an extremely popular novel of the recent times, which is based on Greek mythology, A Song of Achilles by Madeline Miller. Now, this is a book on which I've already done a vlog. You can catch my, raw thoughts there. But this story had me in tears, of course, because of how beautiful it is. Like, it's gut-wrenching, but the story, the way it ends, the way everything is written, you can't help yourself but cry for the characters. Patroclus is such an innocent character. He is so sweet, helpful, and everything, like everything good is there in this character. And then there's Achilles, who's brave, who's powerful. The story has a lot of characters into it. But and the reason why this book is in this list, in this binge-worthy list, is because I actually read it in just 2 days. I really wanted to know what will happen to these characters, their love, their friendship, their bonding, everything. So it is definitely a binge-worthy read, though it's not a thriller, but it's binge-worthy in its own way. Highly recommend A Song of Achilles to all you guys. Last but not the least, I have Earthlings by Sayaka Murata. This is one of my recent reads, which I read as part of a collab that I did with Srishti. You can check out her channel. And this is actually her favorite book, which she recommended to me. This is definitely a binge-worthy book. The writing style is easy yet unique. It is unusual story. This story will definitely surprise you. But what's important is this story will keep you hooked till the end. Also, if you want to read a short story, if you want an extremely fast-paced novel, then this one is for you. It is less than 200 pages as well. This is a story of a girl named Natsuki, and it starts from a from a child age. So she believes that she is not from Earth, and she has this soft toy named Pute, and she believes that she has magical powers as well, and she does not belong to Earth, that she is an alien. And as the story progresses, you'll realize a lot of things about Natsuki, not just about Natsuki, but the society in general. This story is actually like a social commentary where we get to know a lot of societal standards. There is also some abuse, but I would not like to, spoil this book for you, but definitely it is a binge-worthy book to read. I read it in 2 sittings as well. Highly recommend it if you want to read a short story. And yeah, that's it. That's the last book. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you picked one book for yourself. There are a lot of books which are binge-worthy. I will be coming up with more such books for you in the coming future. So let me know if you like watching these kind of videos. I would love to make one more video for you wherein I include another binge-worthy books which you can read, extremely fast-paced books which are unputdownable, because there are a lot of books like these. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this book, and I'll see you later with another video. Till then, bye-bye.